जैसा कि आप सब जानते हैं, हम आपके पूछे हुए क्वेश्चंस और डाउट्स को हमारे फंक्शनल न्यूट्रिशन एक्सपर्ट मोना जौहर तक पहुंचाते हैं, जो हमें उन सवालों के बारे में सही सलाह और राय देती हैं। सो लेट मी वंस अगेन वेलकम मोना जौहर एंड आस्क अस सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस दैट यू ऑल हैव आस्क्ड अस। मोना, द काइंड ऑफ डाइट दैट वी ईट, जो हम खाना खाते हैं पूरे दिन, द काइंड ऑफ लाइफस्टाइल दैट वी हैव, एसिडिटी एक बहुत कॉमन प्रॉब्लम है एंड हमारे पास काफ़ी सवाल आए हैं, काफ़ी क्वेरीज आई हैं, जहाँ लोगों ने हमसे ये पूछा है कि पहले एग्जैक्टली एसिडिटी किसे कहते हैं और फिर उसको कैसे मैनेज किया जाए।
राइट, खूबसूरत। इनफैक्ट द एसिड ब्लॉकिंग मेडिकेशंस, दे आर द थर्ड हाईएस्ट प्रिस्क्राइब्ड मेडिकेशंस इन द वर्ल्ड। सो इतनी ज़्यादा एसिड ब्लॉकिंग मेडिकेशंस प्रिस्क्राइब की जाती है लोगों को। एसिडिटी जो है, कॉमन बिलीफ है कि स्टमक के अंदर बहुत ज़्यादा एसिड बन रहा है, इसकी इसलिए लोग डॉक्टर्स प्रिस्क्राइब करते हैं एसिड ब्लॉकिंग मेडिकेशंस। दे कुड बी H2 ब्लॉकर्स, दे कुड बी PPIs, एनीथिंग। बट इन रियलिटी इट इज़ द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ वेरी लो एसिड इन योर स्टमक।
यू सेइंग फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ फंक्शनल मेडिसिन?
From no, it is very mainstream. That is what happens कि आपके stomach के अंदर acid बहुत कम होता है। जब acid कम होता है, उसकी वजह से आपका जो खाना, जैसे आपने खाना खाया, it goes through your esophagus into your stomach. Now because of low acid in the stomach, this food does not get digested properly because there isn't any enough acid roaming around in the stomach to digest it. Now this will now undigested food tries to come up.
So it regurgitates.
It regurgitates, and if there is a fault in the sphincter, that is the valve that is connecting your stomach to
the lower esophageal sphincter.
Absolutely. So ye khana jo hai ye upar jata hai, and because the esophagus does not have the protective lining to protect against the acid that is now coming into contact, you feel the burning.
And that's why we get heartburn and other symptoms of acidity.
Yes.
So that is basically कि mechanism है कैसे ये problem शुरू होती है। So Mona, हम अक्सर ये भी देखते हैं कि जिस time पे acidity की problem है, उस time पे people just go out and they take these anti-acid gels or they take anti-acid medications for that. So according to your perspective, do you think that they are harmful in the long run?
No, very, very harmful. सबसे पहला जो साइड इफेक्ट होता है, दैट इज़ B12 डिफिशियंसी। सो अ लॉट ऑफ एविडेंस दैट सेज दैट इट लीड्स टू अनीमिया, इट लीड्स टू हिप फ्रैक्चर्स, इट लीड्स टू डिप्रेशन। सो अ होल होस्ट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स दैट आर अकॉम्पनीड विद दिस। ऑल्सो इट लीड्स टू वीक बोन्स, ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस। सो नाउ बिकॉज हमारे स्टमक के अंदर एसिड और कम हो जाता है आफ्टर ईटिंग द एंटासिड्स, आपका खाना ठीक से डाइजेस्ट नहीं होता। अब अगर खाना ठीक से डाइजेस्ट नहीं होगा तो आपके अंदर विटामिन एंड मिनरल डिफिशियंसीज आ जाएंगी, बिकॉज योर बॉडी इज योर फूड इज नॉट प्रॉपरली डाइजेस्टेड।
देयर इज फॉल्टी अब्सॉर्प्शन।
देयर इज फॉल्टी अब्सॉर्प्शन, सो यू विल एंड अप विद विटामिन एंड मिनरल डिफिशियंसीज। सो द स्टमक एसिड हैज़ अ वेरी प्रोटेक्टिव इफेक्ट, एज इन अगर स्टमक एसिड कम होता है तो देयर इज बिग चांस ऑफ बैक्टीरियल ओवरग्रोथ, बिकॉज द एसिड कीप्स इट अंडर चेक। So short term mein to yes, of course it's a band-aid approach, but long term consequences are really dire, so you have to be really careful.
Mona, jahan tak diet ka sawal hai, to kafi viewers humse ye bhi pooch rahe hain ki kis kisam ka khana unko khana chahiye, what are the various lifestyle and dietary modifications that they should do? So kya aisi cheeze hain ki jinko wo avoid kare, and what are the kind of food stuffs that they should have?
So diet and lifestyle changes are really, really important. So the best strategy is to eliminate all fried, all spicy food, tomato-based products and citrus fruits. Aap in sab ko eliminate kariye kareeb 3 hafte ke liye, and then start introducing one thing at a time. Aur jab aap usko introduce karenge to aapko pata lag jayega ki whether it was this one particular food that was causing your symptoms or not. So this is the process of elimination that we use.
तो पहले सबको हटा दें, फिर एक एक करके उनको ऐड करते जाएं और शायद हमको ट्रिगर का पता चले उससे।
Precisely. The other thing that is a huge contributory factor is stress.
Absolutely.
Stress really plays a huge role in this. तो मैं हमेशा हर एक को कहती हूँ कि आप खाने के टेबल पे जब बैठते हैं तो आप डीप ब्रीथ करें, 5 breaths in and 5 counts out. 5 counts in and 5 counts out. Just calm down your system and then start eating. Hopefully it should not trigger.
Yeah, especially with the kind of lifestyle that we have right now, stress is a major contributor towards all the diseases, including acidity, isn't it?
Right. The other foods that could trigger could be processed foods, because they have so many additives, preservatives, chemicals in them. You don't know what could be the cause. So it's best not to eat food that comes out of a packet. Try to eat food that is at home.
And what about raw foods? Are they okay?
Or? Raw foods could either be helpful or not, because it's difficult to digest raw foods.
Yes.
And if you already have low stomach acid, so wo jo raw food hai, uske upar zyada enzymes chahiye hote hain for it to become effective. So a lot of the times people with compromised gut function, they're not able to tolerate raw foods in salads or just otherwise raw
foods.
So
better to limit them?
Better to limit them for a short period of time until you heal, and then introduce them one at a time to see how it's affecting your body. A good quick fix is baking soda. Most houses have baking soda. A teaspoon of baking soda in a glass of water, drink it. It'll subside the symptoms right away.
Probably it'll neutralize the...
It'll neutralize the acids.
Okay, so...
Kai baar hum log kafi recommend karte hain ki aap apple cider vinegar. Apple cider vinegar can work wonders. So just having about 2 tablespoons in your water before a meal will help with the digestion process.
And also ease symptoms.
Another thing that is really awesome is ginger.
Sure.
So ginger tea, of course I do not recommend that anybody drink milk, but just boil some ginger ko koot ke, just like about that big of a ginger, usko acche se koot ke, aap usko paani mein dal ke ubaal lijiye, and you can either drink it hot during the winter months or drink it cold during the summer months. Just keep sipping on it. That really helps with the digestion process.
And keeps the acidity in control.
Under control to a certain extent. Drinking a lot of water always helps. Another quick fix that could help is just lick a bit of salt. That has been known to provide some temporary relief.
Yeah, probably when the symptoms are really worse.
Yeah. So the other things that I always recommend people is that stop eating about 3 hours before you sleep. Bilkul khana khate hi jab aap late jaate hain, to your food, it just, if your sphincter is compromised, the food goes back into your esophagus and causes a heartburn. So give it about 3 hours, let the food leave your stomach, get into the intestines, and then lie down. A lot of the people still have symptoms, then I tell people to raise their bed at the head end. Just about 2 to 4 inches just does the trick.
Because wo reflux ko prevent karega.
Absolutely. And then the other thing that plays a big role is intra-abdominal pressure. So if you have abdominal adiposity, that is like, agar aapke stomach ke around zyada fat hai, तो आपके जो एब्डोमेन में है ज्यादा प्रेशर आ जाता है
तो वो लोग जो मोटे हैं जिनका ज्यादा वजन है
जिनका वजन ज्यादा होता है और स्पेशली जिनका वजन पेट के पास में ज्यादा होता है तो प्रेशर ज्यादा पड़ने की वजह से खाना ऊपर चले जाता है सो लूजिंग वेट ऑलवेज हेल्प्स जब आप खाना खा रहे हैं तो बेल्ट को बहुत ज्यादा टाइट ना रखें थोड़ा सा उसको खुला छोड़ दें ताकि देयर इज लेस ऑफ द इंट्रा एब्डोमिनल प्रेशर
Mona, as far as drinks are concerned, jaise hamari coffee hai, chai hai, limbu pani hai, milk. Many people drink milk, cold milk, when they feel they have a lot of acidity. So, inki kya correlation hai?
So, Khubsura, the three things that you mentioned, coffee, alcohol, and tobacco, they're really, really bad because they relax your sphincter. So, you should try and eliminate them as much as possible.
And what about tea?
Of course, tea has caffeine in it. So, yes, tea would... fall under the category.
So it would be best to limit it as much as
possible.
Yeah, so Mona, what about milk and lemon juice or limu pani? Hamare gharon mein bahut, we drink a lot of limu pani at our home, so what about that?
So limu pani to theek hai, but without sugar.
Okay.
That would be good.
Mm-hmm.
And milk is inflammatory. Mm-hmm. So I ask everybody to avoid milk until the situation is calmed down, until your symptoms have resolved. And then we'll introduce it and see how it affects your body.
Okay. So Mona, in addition to all the advice that you gave, additionally, what do you think that people with acidity should do and how should they go about it?
So I feel they should first follow this protocol, see where the triggers are, and if they are unable to find them, they should absolutely go and consult with their physician and try to figure out why they're having acidity. Because I do not believe in just popping pills. We need to know the reason and we need to eliminate the reason. That's the functional medicine approach.
Thank you, Mona. आपसे बात करके हमें काफी अच्छा लगा और हमारे व्यूअर्स को भी काफी जानकारी मिली. उम्मीद करते हैं कि आप सबको वो क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स मिल गए होंगे जो आप हम सबसे पूछना चाहते थे. अगर आपके जहन में कोई ऐसे सवाल हैं या डाउट्स हैं जो आप फंक्शनल न्यूट्रिशन के रिलेटेड हमसे पूछना चाहते हैं तो प्लीज़ हमसे शेयर करें और जानकारी पाने के लिए www.famhealth.in पे लॉग इन करें.